the coordinator of the Media Alliance of Zimbabwe. I would like to introduce the panelists who are going to be reading the statement and then fielding questions from everyone. To my left, we have the director of the Media Institute of Southern Africa, Mr. Nhlanhla Ngwenya. To my right, Foster Dongozi is the Secretary General of the Zimbabwe Union of Journalists. To my far right is the Director of the Media Center, Mr. Ernest Mzengi. I'll hand over to Foster to read the statement.
Thank you, Comrade Patience. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, colleagues. Welcome to this press conference to speak on preparations for World Press Freedom Day commemorations, the statement. As the world commemorates World Press Freedom Day, the Media Alliance of Zimbabwe, MAS, and partners celebrate the strides made in developing the media sector in Zimbabwe while critically reflecting upon the myriad of challenges facing the industry. Firstly, MAS and partners acknowledge the role played by media practitioners, that is you, the journalists, and the people of Zimbabwe in contributing towards an inquest on the media sector commissioned by the Ministry of Information, Media and Broadcasting Services through the Information Media and Media Panel of Inquiry, IMPI. We applaud the work carried out by IMPI and urge the ministry to facilitate access to the report submitted as it is of public interest. MAS also calls on the ministry to engage media stakeholders on the IMPI report to receive feedback on the findings. MAS partners encourage the ministry to act upon some of the recommendations, specifically expediting the process of aligning media laws and policies to the new constitution and promoting the safety of journalists and media practitioners in Zimbabwe. This also includes, from a labor perspective, the need to expedite the formation of the National Employment Council. MAS prioritizes alignment of media laws and policies to the new constitution to curb the use of media laws that hinder press freedom, diversity and pluralism to regulate the media industry. Of concern is the continued licensing of broadcast media using the Broadcasting Services Act, the continued existence of criminal laws against the media, and the continued regulation of the media under IPAC. In order to address media sustainability challenges that have seen media organizations shutting down and retrenching staff, MAS partners would like to call upon the ministry to develop policies that promote sustainable investment into the industry, specifically relooking at the licensing models, tariff costs on imports of newsprint, among others, and the setting up of standards for viable media business models. And we believe that is something that is possible. A lot of countries in Africa are doing so and are running thriving media. We believe that the survival of media organizations will immensely contribute to a free and diverse media industry. In light of this year's UN Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization, UNESCO theme, Let Journalism Thrive, towards better reporting, gender equality and safety in the digital age, MAS partners would like to call on all stakeholders to uphold media freedom, promote professionalism, gender equality, and respect the media's constitutional rights to protection of sources and access to information without interference. As a way of bringing these and other media issues to the fore, MAS partners and stakeholders have lined up a series of activities in commemorating World Press Freedom Day, which shall be conducted throughout the week. The activities, the activities include media lectures, launching of publications, conferencing and engagement meetings. We look forward to maximum participation by media stakeholders and the public as we strive to make journalism thrive.
A plea to media practitioners themselves to say that even though the statement acknowledges the importance of having the IMPI document as a lobby tool, that report unfortunately will suffer the same fate as other reports that have been compiled in the past. If we as media players do not give it ample space in our platforms, which platforms we have control over, we need to motivate our members of the public. We need to engage in dialogue and debate around the contents of that report. Without us, no one else will. So it will be forgotten, just like other reports that have been published in the past. So I urge all of us to read the report. Is there available? I'm sure all of us here sitting in front of you have the report. If you need the report, we can easily make it available to you electronically. And I understand IMPI is also producing hard copies that will be distributed nationwide. Let us dialogue and engage on matters that affect our industry. Because if we don't do it, no one else will. That is a call from me with regards to the realignment of laws.
Thank you, Nkla.
Ernest? Yes, we recognize that we have had some few improvements here and there. We have had some achievements here and there. But by and large, we are celebrating when in actual fact mourning the continued death of media freedom in Zimbabwe. I take note that what we have only had are improvements on paper and by word of mouth. I think on paper in reference to the new constitution, that on paper guarantees media freedom, the right of access to information, and so on and so forth. But in actual practice, we don't have that. People are disappearing for expressing themselves. People, journalists are being arrested. They continue to be arrested under criminal defamation laws. Yes, the Minister of Information has been heard castigating criminal defamation. But the powers that be, those are above him, I have actually been heard promoting criminal defamation, saying that it is necessary that we have such laws. For example, recently we had the Vice President actually trying to justify criminal defamation. And we are saying that media freedom is only guaranteed on paper and by word of mouth. We want to see our government walking the talk and also walking what is written on paper. It is only when then that we can meaningfully celebrate World Press Freedom Day. I think my colleague, they pointed out the issue of the march that was actually stopped last year. We are still in such a scenario where there is no freedom of expression, and even after expression, to make matters worse. So we want a situation, as has been said, where all the laws that criminalize free expression and freedom of the media to be done away with, so that we can maybe the other year celebrate Press Freedom Day meaningfully.